there is a relation between me and radio. Either radio comes to me or I go behind the radio.
Since the 1980s, Uday Kalburgi, a telecom consultant in Bengaluru, has collected over 150 rare antique radios, most of which work. These rare radios make up his world. So when you take a step into Uday's radio museum, you travel back in time.
If I don't listen to the morning signature tune of Akashwani, I miss my day.
Uday Kumar's fascinating collection of radios is housed in the basement of his home in Basveshwar Nagar. He officially opened this museum on February 13, 2021 on World Radio Day. Many of these radios have been bought by Uday and many are family heirlooms donated to him. Not too many of them can play FM stations. They are mostly shortwave radios which consist of valves instead of transistors. What is a valve, you ask? This here is a valve. Uday made this transparent model of valve radio especially for people like you and me who have zero idea about this. This vacuum sealed bulb like object needs to be switched on so that filament lights up. This takes nearly 3 minutes. Only then the sound is emitted. Since a valve radio takes up so much energy, the size of these radios is huge.
So nanige enandre adanna yaru design maadi aa time nal madidare they were brilliant people. Okay, so adanna uliskobeku anta heli nanu valve radio galna collect madak shuru madide.
By 1959-60, they became obsolete as much smaller transistor radios started entering the market and they became popular due to their small size. I mean, look at this one. How can anyone carry this?
Between 1985 and 90, 70% of Indian radios, they were all made as scrap. So none of those radios are available. So even now, today in 2021, you get hardly any wall radio which is working.
While no one uses the valve radios anymore, Uday is fascinated with the technology. Whenever someone approaches him with a valve radio, he restores it for them. Mind you, not repair, but restore. When manuals and schematics are not available, he draws by hand. Take this radio for example. This is pilot radio made in the US in 1935. One of the rare pieces that was brought to Uday by Padmanabha Varma of Travancore royal family to restore. Uday had to use coral draw to make this dial and procure the glass dome and the needle from London, the speaker cloth from Holland and two valves from Australia. Finally, when it was ready, the royal family scion gave it back to Uday as an inauguration gift for the museum.
Once I restore that radio, I search on the web for the audio. So I download that voice, connect it to the radio. So when you listen to that audio from that particular era radio, it really gives me goosebumps, you know, as if I'm listening to the radio in 1945.
Hostilities will end officially at 1 minute after midnight tonight, Tuesday, the 8th of May.
I'm not here. But I went back, and once it starts singing, that is the beauty of it.
Each radio here has a story. A radio which is a testament to a son's love for his father who listened to it until his death. Another that played the songs for a couple until the wife died. A radio which ended up in India only because its owner, a British soldier, never returned to collect it. Along with emotional value, each radio represents a milestone in the history of science and technology. That's why Uday is so enthusiastic about leaving this knowledge to the younger generation.
All these radios are not just dummy radios. There is a lot of theoretical things which has gone behind this. This design of radio is not so easy, not so simple. Many scientists, people have worked on it to bring a radio to a functional state. So that is what is important, that basics of electronics, electrical engineering is behind these radios. That is what I want to tell them, you learn that. So such radios, you have to preserve it, it's a history. So my idea is of the museum is only to preserve that history.
If you wish to contact Uday Kalburgi to visit the museum or get your old radio restored, contact number is in the description.